Conductor, we're being held at this signal to allow an eastbound train to pass. We have clearance to proceed when the signal clears. Hello, and welcome to episode 45 of Trains in World Shorts. We're on Cane Creek today. We will take the siding at Brendel, where we are to set out five tank cars from behind our engines. And this is what we're driving. A couple of AC4400s. And about 3,000 ton. Right, we've got the green signal to go. Let's go. Set the other camera up at the back. And we are fully loaded. So I think we are going here to set out, and then we wait, I think, to join the main line. So let's get on our way. Sirens abound. That's what it'll only be us on this thing. Right. Right. They really need to sort that out, because there's no road near here and there's no cars running either. I'm eating a bit of chocolate, so yeah, bear with me. They've got two AC4400s in this. About 28 wagons, about 3,000 ton. Very basic controls on here. So a mile away from Brendel passing siding east. I'm just starting to slow down for a 30 mile an hour limit. Top speed on here is 60 miles an hour, lowest speed is about 15. Most of it is 25 mile an hour on the branch line. Got a red light signal next. So we've got to drive past this third siding as directed and stop as indicated. So that line there is the branch where you take, go off down on the branch. This is still the single track main line here. So we got to stop there. I think Tear Chappie route would be a nice route to have for Trains in World. Obviously, there'd be a problem with BNSF logos and everything, licenses. But the godsend about that is Union Pacific and BNSF share trackage rights. So in effect, it can be done. Something else I need to check in a minute as well. Split the train behind the first five tank cars. We must then spot these on the stub track next to us. So I saw something just as we walked up here, so as we came back up here, so I wanted to look at, I wonder if these are loaded. I just thought they are loaded, but if anyone can put in the comments, no, they're empty. Okay, so what are the tank cars used for then on the route? I'll come back to them in a minute because I want to go past just up here. There's one here. The collectibles. Brendel, originally named Crescent and later Crescent Junction. This place really only exists because of the railroad passing siding. The small yard sees occasional deliveries of fuel tank cars. So, the thing is, great, but where does the fuel go? Do they get stationed here and then stuff trucks come along? That road noise is so annoying. They really, really have to sort that out because that is one of the bad things on here. There's a couple of other bugs that hopefully they'll sort out, like the bogies trucks on the rear of the AC4400s don't go down, don't go round. Utah Division. This railroad line is part of the vast Utah Division of the Union Pacific Railroad. If we were to follow the tracks in the westward direction, we would get to Salt Lake City. That's cool. That's annoying that it disappears. I think that's just a bug.
Mind the gap.
Oh, don't worry about that. So these... These are the new wagons. No, sorry. These are reskins of the old DTG and this Canadian Pacific and CSX hopper wagons. These are the new wagons that have been built, that have been made. One up here. Oh, we can't go up any further, can we? Can we go up there? I don't think it'll let us. It might go up. Let us go up there. Yeah, we can. So these are the new ones. That's all the loaded stuff. That's pretty cool. Won't let me cross, which is really stupid. Alright, so let's go back to the thing and we'll uncouple. These are the hoppers that were on the Peninsula Corridor, reused. At least I think, I'm quite sure that we can actually use those. Obviously we can, you should be able to use those in Livery Creator. Kind of hoping we've got enough room between there actually, which I think we have. That's where we go. And I've got to make sure because the signals went left, right. And there we go. So then we'll just spot these over here on this track. Just going to make sure that the other, where are we? There we are. Then we got to go. So that one's not done. That's got to be done. So the level crossings aren't working yet. Properly yet. Apparently they do, some of them work and some of them don't, so yeah, figure that one out. Right, I just need to reverse these back on the other side. The horn's a bit crap, but there you go. So do it the old fashioned way. Sport and uncouple, let's pick up the rest of our train again and then we can proceed. Actually, it's not a bad little picture that. Actually, it would be better if I did it in there. So if I was to do 8, a nice overall shot of our pictures, of our load. I like that. Right, let's go and pick up the rest of the train. Guess what I forgot to do? Should have been using the independent brake from the start, to be honest, because I was going around in the wagons. Let's proceed to the siding, which is just around the corner. And then we'll... I think that's the end of the thingy then. So that's that one. So the other one. So chuck her down there. Ooh, forgot about that one there, look. It's a bit of a nice route to do walking the route. It's not going to be as busy. And that's where we stop there. Could have gone a little bit better. And there we go. It's not the best way I've done it, but I have done this one before, so I've already got a goal for it. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. It's not my best effort, but yeah, a couple of mistakes made. I did it first live actually, which is pretty cool. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope to see you in the next one. If you have enjoyed it, leave us a like, leave us a sub. Don't forget to hit the bell icon, think about joining the Discord server. So yeah, there's special events going on there. We do run competitions from time to time, but yeah. And you also get to choose what routes I drive in my live streams as well, every now and then. So yeah, so thank you all very much. I hope to see you again at some point. And until then, I will speak to you later. Goodbye.